Brother Bolin, is that you? Praise the builder. I thought I heard you enter the church, but when I turned to greet you, someone struck me, and I awoke here. Bolin, you were called here tonight for an important reason. There's a letter in my office, and you must read it. The office is locked, but you can find the key inside the church pulpit.
Cockwit is gonna get past me. Thank you. me.
Move along now. Huh?
maybe it was a rat.
That was there before.
Hey, who took this?
Captain, why we gotta stay out here so late? It's dark, and I haven't had my dinner yet.
You've got your orders. Word is that a prowler's gonna try breaking into the manor tonight. Our job is to stop him.
But, Captain, I was thinking... What if...
You just leave the thinking to me, Herschel. I'm better at it. Stand here and stop anyone looking suspicious. I'll guard the road.
Oh, yes, sir.
Thank you. Hello, stranger. I'm so sorry that it's quiet in here. I used to be full of songs to sing, but I fear that my muse has left me. If you could bring some inspiration, I would be ever so grateful.
Is someone there? You are from the church. Thank the builder you have come. Priest, I am dying. But before I pass, I need your help. There is an evil in this house that has haunted me my entire life. I fear if it is not uprooted, then my children will suffer the same fate that I have. I have no more strength to talk. There is a letter on the desk behind you. Please, read it. Builder, have mercy on my sins.
Thank you. to this night.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. thank you, stranger, for putting me to rest. If you see my son, tell him I love him, and tell him to beware of those he thinks are friends. In this house, nothing is as it seems.
Is that you? Priest, I am glad that you are here. Until I wrote my confession, I never spoke to anyone about my father's murder. I always told myself that this was because I might be killed if I spoke. But this house, my title, all that I owned was received when my father died. They were gifts given to me by my father's killer. Was I silent because of them? Was it love of money that kept my lips shut? The only way I can find peace is if you are successful in your search.
Mm-hmm. Hello? Can you hear me? Up here, into the attic. Closer, just a little bit closer. I'm so glad you've come. It's been so long since I've spoken to anyone. Have you seen Janina? She's a servant who works here in the house. Don't tell anybody, but we're in love. We were supposed to meet up here in order to run away together, but she hasn't shown up yet. I'm starting to worry that something's happened to her. Can you go down to the servant's quarters and see that she's safe?
Thank you, kind stranger, for helping me find my voice. May the Builder bless you always.
The city's crawling with thieves lately. Well, I'm ready if need be.
Much the same as any other night.
What made that sound?
Thank you.
thirsty.
Turn out the lights. And now they want to raise taxes again. Well, you know, if I light it, it's just going to keep going out.
Yes,
Before they finally listen.
Thank you for reuniting us. Our separation is finally over. Growing up in this house was like living in a gilded cage. No matter what any of us did, it always pulled us back in. Don't you get caught in its web too.
Please come close.
Early on the morning of the 23rd of January 1999, in an isolated village in India, an Australian Christian missionary, Graham Staines, was murdered.
In Australia, his death was in the headlines for a few days, but in India, it has become a rallying point for those outraged by acts of violence. This program looks at the life of Graham Staines, from his home in Queensland, on to his remarkable work in India, and to the death of a missionary. Tonight, 8:30.
Coming up on ABC, after a heavy night, Derek has more waiting for him than just a hangover on the bill. Following Inside Story, foreign correspondent reports on the heated debate in Britain over genetically modified food and the threat to the natural balance from Frankenstein foods. Then on Late Line, guest presenter Catherine Jobe discovers the great disruption.
The builder will call me home to his side soon. I can feel it. All my life, this house, my wealth, has been my prison. The fear of losing it kept me silent about even my father's death. It is a terrible thing to be a slave. We are all destined to be captive to something in this life. I just pray that my children can be held by bonds of love and hope, not by bonds of greed. Please, priest, don't let them suffer my fate.
In 1992, when she was only 7, Fortune magazine placed her in the league of the super rich, the world's youngest billionaire.
They say that money can't buy happiness.
There is this curse that hangs over the house of Onassis.
For one little girl, money has replaced her privacy, her innocence, and a normal life. As sole surviving heir of the Greek tycoon Aristotle Onassis, Athena Roussel is the richest little girl in the world. Tonight at 8:30 on ABC.
Coming up on ABC, George is in trouble with his superiors and the public over his attitude on the bill. Following Inside Story, the richest little girl in the world, foreign correspondent reports from Papua New Guinea, where a government, desperate for cash, is logging the forests. Then Late Line discusses media ethics in the wake of the John Laws allegations. That's tonight on ABC.
Thank you. it's almost done.
Gonna get me a good oar after this.
Doing down here?
Hello, Rupik.
I told you to clean the rooms on the second floor, not loaf about the manor.
But I was just...
Oh, but, Carlotta, get back up there and don't let me catch you away from your post again.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
it! You killed the bad man! I'm free from the nightmares, thanks to you. But he's still there, isn't he? Back in your world. And he's still mad at you. Watch yourself, my friend.
Blame that one on me. I wasn't even there. She's not going to be happy about this, that's for sure. Bugger it.
What was that?
Well, maybe I'd get more done if you didn't nag me all the time. That's what I should have said.
Was killed because I came too close to the Manor's secrets. Guard yourself, else the house devour you too.
until you have arrived. Come out into the open that I may see you. I survived the Death Lovers, the Hammer Lovers, the Key Lovers, and I will survive you. And times which you can't possibly imagine. I'm the only one who has survived. If you kill me, there will be nothing left.
No!
Hello, my friend. All my life I have lived in fear. Fear of my sins, and fear of what was to come. For ages my whole family has lived under that cloud, trapped by a monster we never even knew was there. But now, it feels like the long night has passed, and that the curse has been lifted. No matter what may happen next, we are free, and we can never repay you for that gift. It is the Builder's work to bind up the brokenhearted and set free those who are enslaved. Thank you for doing the Builder's work for us this night. May he bless your path and guide you always.
Me anyway.